morning, children.
How are you all?
I hope you are fine. Yes, in the last class we have started with rational number, isn't it? Rational number is not new for us, but we have started calculating rational number based on addition and subtraction, isn't it? First, actually we are going to see all the mathematical operations using rational number. First, we have started with addition and subtraction. In that we have started with the intro part and basic problems of addition and subtraction. Okay, just we will recall once and we will go for the solving problem. What is the rational number? Rational number is the set of all integers and number in the form of p by q. In other words, a number in the form of p by q and q is not equal to 0, p and q or any integer is called as the rational number. The symbol for rational number is q. Okay, rational number includes integers, natural number and whole number. Isn't it? Yes. And we have discussed about the absolute value. Okay, by seeing the symbol itself, I told that it is the absolute value. The symbol will give you the absolute value, not less symbol. And how to write the rational number in the standard form. Have you recall how to convert the number in the standard form? What are the 2 points you have to remember? One is the denominator should be positive. The denominator is always positive, isn't it? And the numerator and denominator should not have any other common factor other than 1. Such numbers are called in the, they are in the standard form. Yes? And we have solved some problems finding the rational number between the rational numbers and how to add and subtract the rational numbers. Okay. First, we start with the simple problems. Here also I have some example. First, we are going to solve the basic problems of addition and subtraction of rational numbers. Here also you have to remember always the final answer should be in the standard form. Okay. First, we'll see this problem, then we will go for the next operations. Okay. First, see here example 1. I gave here 5 set of problems. First, we will solve 1 by 1. First, take the first problem. A. 12 by 5 plus of minus 13 by 6. Here, 12 by 5 and minus 13 by 6 both are rational number. We have to add. What is the operation here? We have to add this. Before that, we have to use the rules. We studied the rules of integers for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. We studied the integers rule. Isn't it in this chapter itself? First, we have studied it. Using that rule also used here. Okay. First, what is the first step what we have to do? Before adding. Okay. First, we will see the denominator. If the denominators are same, we can add the numerator as it is or subtract the numerator as it is. If the denominators are different, we have to take the LCM. We have to take the LCM. Then only we have to equate the denominator. Then only we have to add or subtract the numbers. First, before that, what is the first step we have to do? I am having a symbol here. Plus or minus. So, plus into minus. First, change in the form. 12 by 5. This will be multiplied. Here, we have to use the operation multiplication. This will be multiplied. The symbol will be multiplied with the next number. So, plus into minus. What is the integer rule? Plus into minus is minus. So, minus 13 by 6. First, change the question like this. See the question, if you have any symbol to multiply or take it into the bracket, first you do the then you go for the calculation. So plus into minus is minus. Okay, now we have to subtract. What we have to do? We have to check the denominator. See the denominator, here it is 12 by 5, here it is 13 by 6. 5 and other one is 6. They are not same, they are different. So what do you have to do? We have to take the LCM. We have to take the LCM. So, we know that we will do like this, 5, comma 6. Here, 5 is a prime number, okay. So, if you also see once, 1, 5 is 5. And 6 will not be divided. Again, 2, 3 is a 6 and 3 is a 6, 4 with 6 itself. Okay, only one number. So, 6 into 5, LCM 6 times a 13. Likewise. So, whenever you are finding a prime number doesn't have a factor other than that. So, you can directly multiply and take the LCM. Okay, so without doing the division method, we can take 5, 6 are 30. So the LCM of the two number, 5 into 6 is 30. Yes, now what we have to do is, we have to equate the denominator of the given number to the LCM. Okay, both the numbers to the
HCM, then you can add or subtract.
Take the first number. What's the first number we are having?
12 by 5.
12 by 5.
What I say? You have to equate the denominator to the LCM.
So, what should be multiplied by 5?
With 5 to get 30.
Okay, I want 30 as the answer. So, what number should be multiplied with 5 to get the answer 30?
It's 6 5s are 30.
6 into 5 will give you the value 30.
So, 12 by 5 is equal to 12 by 5 into 6 by 6.
This number you only have to choose according to the LCM.
See here the denominator is 5, but I got the LCM as 30.
LCM of the two denominators as 30.
So what you have to do is, for each number you have to make the denominator as the LCM, equal to the LCM.
So here 5 is 30.
So 5, what number if you multiply with 5 will become as 30?
6.
So I am multiplying the number 6.
We have to multiply both to the numerator as well as to the denominator. 6 if you chose this, we have to multiply both with the numerator as well as with the denominator.
So if you multiply
6 5s are 30.
So the denominator will become 30.
Now multiply 6 2s are 12.
Remind of 1. 1 6 is 72.
12 into 6 is 72.
Okay.
Now choose the second number. What is the next number we have to subtract?
30 by 6.
30 by 6. Here the denominator is 6, but I want to make it as 30. So what number if you multiply with 6?
There is the denominator will change as 30.
A 6 5s are 30.
So 13 into 5 by 6 into 5.
Same number you have to multiply for the numerator as well as for the denominator.
So see, 6 5s are 30 and 30 into 5.
65.
Now see, we got that these two numbers if I change 12 by 5 as 72 by 30 in equivalent fractions only.
13 by 6 as 65 by 30.
So which is equal?
This is equal to 72 by 30 and 13 by 6 is equal to 65 by 30.
Now what is the value that we want to find?
72 by 30 minus 65 by 30.
We have to subtract this now.
What is 72 minus 65?
It is 7.
7 by 30.
So the final answer for this
12 by 5 plus of minus 13 by 6 is 7 by 30.
So whenever you are having a fraction or ratio number to add or subtract, you have to follow this procedure.
First see the symbols. Any change or anything we have to do in the symbol.
Okay, first check in the standard form. Then go for the denominator.
If the denominators are same, you can directly do it. Otherwise, check the LCM.
Okay.
If I don't know, if prime numbers, just multiply directly the two numbers and give the LCM.
And equate the given numbers to the denominator.
Then add up
whatever the symbols.
Here it is subtraction. So we are subtracting the value and the value is equal to 7 by 30.
Okay.
Now we'll go for the second problem. Problem number B.
2.
What is it?
44 by 12,
44 by 12
minus
36 by 7,
minus 36 by 7.
Now, we have to get the LCM, isn't it? Here nothing sign is that, direct subtraction only, so we have to get the LCM for this.
So, why we are finding the LCM?
Because the denominators are different. If you want to subtract, you have to take the LCM, then only we have to do.
Okay.
Why I am doing this is, this, if you are clear with the simple basic problems, two digit subtraction or one subtraction, one value, one term, three term subtraction only, you can do the sum simplification, evaluation, that sums you can do. If you are enough strong in this solving first two terms, three terms, just how to take the LCM, if you are very clear in that part only, you can solve the upcoming problems.
So only I am giving this much example for you.
Okay.
Now,
12.
The LCM of, you have to find the LCM of 12, 7.
So see, 7 is a prime number. There is no common factor for 12 and 7.
So just we can directly multiply and take the LCM.
Okay. So instead of doing the division, 7 is a prime number.
Isn't it?
7. And 12 and 7 doesn't have any common factor. So just
have to subtract this. So it will be 4. Common denominator we are taking it as 84, and the numerator is 308 minus 432.
So we have to subtract the numerator. So 432 minus 432 is the bigger number. Okay. So we have to subtract 432, which is minus 124 by 84. See, 432 minus 308. What is the value? 124 by 84. Greater number is minus 432. So we are taking the greater number symbol minus. I mean, we are using the rules of integer here. Okay. So now you have to whether the answer is in the standard form. See, the denominator is not in the negative. So it is the standard form? No. If the denominator is positive, but the common factor for the numerator and denominator is not 1. So we have to simplify. That is the option of simplifying this number. It is, we can reduce this number. So reduce by 4. If I reduce by 4, 3 4s are 12 and 1 4 is 4. And denominator, if we reduce by 4, 2 4s are 8 and 1 4 is 4. See, here we are having 31 by 21. For 31 and 21, we are having common factor 1 only. But see, which type of fraction it is? It is improper fraction. So, we have to check with the standard form. Yes, it is in the standard form. The denominator is not negative and the common factor is 1. But the answer should not be in the form of improper fraction. If it is an improper fraction, what we have to do? We have to change to the mixed fraction. Yes, very good. What we have to do? If the answer comes in improper fraction, we have to change it to the mixed fraction. So if you change the mixed fraction, how many times of 21? In 31, one time. So 110 by 21 minus. See how we will change. Divide 31 by 21. If you divide 31 by 21, 31 by 21. How many times? 121 is 21. Remainder 10. So in this way only we have to write. So quotient, remainder and divisor. So minus 1, 10, 21 is the final answer. So why I took this sum is, see, we are having a bigger number as a LCM. And subtraction also. Here we are using the integer rule. Okay, if greater plus minus this, we have to subtract and put the greater number sign. As well as we are simplifying the answer to the standard form. So after the standard form, the answer in the mixed improper fraction. So we have to get the knowledge. If improper fraction is there, we have to change to the mixed fraction as the final answer. Okay. Yes. Now see the third problem. 11 by 21. 11 by 21 plus minus 9 by 21. See here, the denominators are same. So what do you have to do? We have to change the sign. So 11 by 21. What we have to do? If like this, if the bracket is there, first we have to take the symbol inside. So plus, if it comes inside as a multiplication. So plus into minus is minus. Minus 9 by 21. It is simple problem. After taking the sign inside, 21, 21, both the denominators are same. So our work is easy. What we have to do? We have to subtract the numerator as it is. So 11 minus 9 by 21. What is 11 minus 9? It is 2 by 21. What is the answer? 11 minus 9? 2 by 29. Here, greater number also plus only. So, plus 2 by 21. Check whether the answer in the standard form. Yes, the denominator doesn't have a positive number. And 2 and 21, that is a common factor. And it is in proper fraction only. Okay. So, next we will solve the next two problems. Now we will solve the fourth problem. So, b minus 5 by minus 8 minus of minus 3 by 4. So, before subtracting this, see the signs. Okay, change of the standard form of sign. So, change the signs and multiply the sign with the next number and change to the standard form. Now we are having 5 by 8 plus 3 by 4. We have the address 2, but we are having the different denominators. Okay, 8 comma 8 and 4. So what is the LCM for 8 and 4? They are not prime numbers, so go with it. Okay, should we go with 2? 4 is 8, 2 is 4. Again by 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1. So what is the LCM? LCM is equal to 2 into 2, which is equal to 8. So the LCM of 4 comma 8 is equal to 8, because 4 is the factor of 8. Because factor means divide the number with the remainder. Okay. Also it is a multiple of 8. 4 is 8. So the greatest number is 8 here. The LCM is 8. Now, what we have to do? We got the LCM as 8. So choosing 5 by 8. 5 by 8. Already here the denominator is 8. LCM is also 8. So nothing to multiply. If you want, we can take it as 1 by 1. But if you are very low, isn't it? We are not in the standard. We know that nothing to multiply. So we can calculate this directly as 5 by 8. 3 by 4. Should be multiplied by 2. Because 2 is 6 and 4 is 8. To make 4 as 8, we have to multiply by 2. So what are the numbers we are having now? 5 by 8. Plus 6 by 8. 5 plus 6 is 11 by 8. Whether the answer is the standard form, it is not having negative in the denominator and no factor other than 1, but it is in the form of AS, improper fraction. So we have to change to the mixed fraction code. So what we have to do? We have to divide 11 by 8. So 18 is 8 and the remainder is 3. 8 plus 3 is 11. So 18 is 8 plus 3 is 11. So the final answer is 1, 3 by 8. Okay. So whenever you are finding the signs, make the signs of the numerator, denominator have both minus. Simplify that. And minus of any number, if you are having bracket or minus of plus of any other sign, just multiply to the next number, then find the answer for this. Okay. Now, minus 3 by 8. Minus 3 by 8. Plus 5 by minus 12, plus 5 by minus 12. Is it possible to direct both the calculation directly by taking the LCM? No, before that we have to check the sign. So minus 3 by 8, here nothing to cancel, so keep as it is minus 3 by 8. Here in the denominator we are having minus. Okay, so if you take to the numerator, it becomes minus 5 by 12. Again we have to multiply this sign, so it will be changes minus 3 by 8 plus into minus is minus 5 by 12. Plus into minus is minus 5 by 12. Now, just we have to subtract the numbers minus 3 by 8 and 5 by 12, but the denominators are not same. So what we have to do? We have to take the LCM. So for 8 and 12, we take the LCM. What is the common factor? 2. So 4 plus 8, 6 plus 12. Again, we are having the common factor 2. 2 plus 4, 3 plus 6. Nothing is more. So 2, 1, 3, again 3, 1. So what is the LCM? 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, 2 cube into 3, that is 8 into 3. So 8 is a 24. We are having the LCM for 8 and 12 is 24. Okay, so except prime number, don't multiply any number directly, just take the LCM and find the answer. Okay, so now we know that the LCM is 24. We have to take the number and equate the denominator to the LCM. So minus 3 by 8. What number should be multiplied with 8 to get the number 24? What number? See the multiples of 8. 8 is a 24. So we have to multiply minus 3 by 8 into 3 by 3. So 3 3 is a minus 9. 8 3 is a 24. Choose the second, take the second number, 1 by 12. What number should be multiplied with 12 to get 24? Because we have to equate to 24, no? 2. Yes, very good. 2. So 5 is a 8, 12 is a 24. Now we got the answer. So subtracting minus 9 by 24, minus 10 by 24. Minus minus means what we have to do? Yes, we have to add. Same sign means we have to add and put the same sign. So minus 10 minus 9 is minus 19 by 24. Minus 19 by 24. Also the answer comes in lines in the standard form. Here the answer is in going to see the some more problems on the basis. Now see children, in exercise 4.2 already we solved the first two problems. Now the third problem. See, whatever we worked on as a of example, that example will be very useful to solve such problems. Okay. Now evaluate 5 plus 3 by 7 minus of 4 minus 2 by 9. Here we have to use the rule. Okay, what must rule? First we have to solve the bracket of multiplication, division and addition, subtraction. That rule we have to follow and then we have to solve. Okay. First we have to solve the numbers inside the bracket. Okay. So we have to open the bracket. That means remove the bracket, then we have to add the other numbers. First. 5 plus 3 by 7 minus, before getting the minus inside, solve the number inside the bracket. So what we are having? 4 minus 2 by 9. Okay, here we are having a rational number. So 4 is also a rational number. So the denominators are not same. 4 can be considered as 4 by 1. We can take it as 4 by 1. So we have to take LCM, then only we have to subtract these two numbers. So if we consider 1 here for that ratio, if I consider 1 here, for 1 and 9, what is the LCM? 9 only. 9 except the LCM. So if we take 9. Okay. So we did it first in the simple problems. We took 4. What is the number to make it as 9? Denominator as 9. We multiply. Simple numbers, you can do them directly. Okay. So 1. Here the denominator is 1. So 1 into 9 is 9. So what should we multiply with 4? 4 minus 36. 1 should 1. If we want to make 1 as 9, we should multiply by 9. The same thing should be multiplied with the numerator. So 4 minus 36. Here 9. The LCM also 9. So nothing to multiply with the numerator, multiply by 1. So the 1 into 2 is 2. Now 5 plus 3 by 7 minus 36 minus 2. We have to subtract now. 36 minus 2 is 34 by 9. If you want, if it is possible to simplify, we can simplify also and then solve. Yes. Now, before this, now we get a single number. Okay, so minus of, we can take minus inside, minus 34 by 9. So we can rewrite as 5 plus 3 by 7 minus 34 by 9. First, at time we can add this 3, but first we will solve the 2 number. With the result of that number, we will add the third number. Subtract the third number. Okay. So here, for instance, we can consider it as 1. We don't this 1. For 1 and 7, the LCM is 7. In the same way, I told you 1. If you want to consider as 7, what should you multiply? 7. So multiply the same number with the numerator. So 7 times are 35 minus. Plus is there, so plus, already 7 is there, so 1 is to multiply with the numerator, it's enough, or take the numerator as it is. Okay, minus 34 by 9. What is 35 plus 3? Here we are adding addition only, let's add it. Okay, first you solve this. 35 plus 3 is 38, so 38 by 7, middle minus 34 by 9. 7 is a prime number and for 7 and 9 there is no common factor. So to take the LCM for 7 and 9, LCM for 7 comma 9, just multiply the two numbers, which is equal to 7 times 63. So we can take the LCM by directly multiplying 7 and 9. 7 times 63. So the LCM is 63. Okay. So otherwise if you want, you can go in the order itself. Okay. So what we will do first? First problem for it also to as 38 by 7. I want to make the denominator to the equal to the LCM 63. So what should be multiplied with 9 to make it as 63? Sorry, 7. That is 9. So 9. 9 sevens are 63. And 38 into 9. 38 into 9 is 342. Take the second number. Okay. If you want, after the practice, if you are very good, first in taking the LCM and making the denominator equivalence, you can do it directly. Okay. But first time we are practicing now, so take single number and equate the denominator, take the other number, equate the denominator, then add a subtract. Okay. Then 34 by 9. Next number. What number should be multiplied with this? Yes.
42 by 63 minus 238 by 63. If we subtract this, 342 minus 238. So the answer is 104. Yes, 104 by 63. So see, we got the answer is 104 by 63. But whether it is in the standard form, no, it is an improper fraction. So what we have to do, we have to change to the mixed fraction. So how to change? We have to divide 104 by 63. 104 by 63. One time only possible, because 16 into 2 will become 120 something. So one time only possible. So 63. What is the remainder? 1 and 4, 41. So how to write it? Yes. 1 times of 63 plus 41. 1 into 63 plus 41 will give you the answer 104. So this is the final answer. So we are having one or two operations, and more than two rational numbers, let's go with the rule. Okay, go with the rule of mathematics. First remove the bracket, solve the number inside the bracket, and then remove the bracket, then go with the rules of rational numbers, addition, subtraction, rational numbers. See how we got this part. Okay, this part, after taking the LCM, just I'm taking single number each and then equating to the denominator. If by practicing, you can do it directly as here. Okay, how we are finding 97 directly, we are multiplying with the numerator now. We can do directly also. Okay, so yes, now this is the next problem. Now see the fourth question. Add the difference of 2 by 3 and 3 by 5 to their sum. Here they didn't give the question directly, they gave a clue word using that we have to arrange the question. Okay, so see, add the difference of 2 by 3 and 3 by 5 to their sum. So to the sum of them, so how to do that now? Sum, first you will add 2 by 3 plus 3 by 5. To this sum, we have to add their difference. Add means we have to use plus. Difference. Difference is 2 by 3 minus 3 by 5. See, to the sum, we are adding their difference. Okay, so we change the question as a problem. So how to find the answer? Yes. Now we have to simplify this and get the answer. First, if we add this, first you will solve this and next this. In the bracket, then you will add the two results. Okay. 3 and 5. 3 and 5 are prime numbers. So the LCM of 3, 5. This 5 is 15. We can give the LCM directly as 15. Okay. Now, what is the LCM here? 15. So what should we multiply with 3? 5. So 5 is 10. The same, here we should multiply by 3. So 3 threes are 9. But the numerator also but the same. See, here also much not much difference, because the same number we are subtracting now. So the LCM is 15. The numerator also 5 threes are 10 minus 3 threes are 1. What is 10 plus 9? It is 19 by 15. Plus of, we have to subtract 10 minus 1 minus 1 by 15. We have to add this. So we have to change the standard form. This can be simplified by 5. So simplify by 5. So 4 5s are 20. And 3 5s are 15. So we can write it as finally 4 by 3. Now also it is an improper fraction. So change to the mixed fraction. Small number only now. So 1 3 is 3. 1 3 is 3. 3 plus 1 is 4. Or if we divide 4 by 3, the remainder will be 1. So 1 3 by 4. So whenever you are getting statement problem like this, convert that statement into the problem and solve and find the answer. Okay. Let's see the next question. What number should be subtracted from 4 by 7 minus 2 by 3 to get 3 by 5? This is the question. So what number should be subtracted? So from this number, we have to subtract some number so that the answer should be 3 by 5. We gave the answer, but the unknown number we have to find. That unknown number, let it be x. We are taking the unknown number be yes. Okay. So how to convert the question as a problem? 4 by 7 minus 2 by 3. Some number is subtracted from this. That number only we are taking plus x. But the answer is equal to 3 by 5. From this, if we are subtracting some number, the answer is equal to 3 by 5. So we are taking that unknown number as x. we can take any variable. Just we are taking unknown number as max. Probably we will take the unknown value as x. We are choosing it as x. Now, how to solve this? First, we will solve this. Make it as a single number. After that, taking x to the next side of the equation, the number to the next side of the equation, we will find the value of x. So, first, we will concentrate on this. 4 by 7 minus 2 by 3. We have to subtract. For our convenience, we can use the bracket. First, we will solve this. For 7 and 3, it is not a same, so we have to take the LCM. So, what is the LCM of 7 and 3? 7 threes are 21 because they are prime number now. So, 7 threes are 21. So, they multiply the numerator directly. So, 7 into 3 will give you 21. So, multiply by 3 by 4. 4 threes are 12. Minus here, I should multiply by 7. So, 7 twos are 14. So, 12 minus 14 minus 6 is equal to 3 by 5. What is 12 minus 14? 14 is a greater number. We have to subtract. So 14 minus 12 is 2. And the greater number sign is minus. So we are using minus. Minus 2 by 21 minus x is equal to 3 by 5. But what we have to do? We have to find the value of x here. So I am going to change x to the x side. Minus x is there. So if it goes there, it will become plus x. And 3 by 5 here. Because we arrange numbers in one side and unknown variable in the other side, only we can identify the unknown variable easily. So in the next step, we are going to move x to the next side of the equation and 3 by 5 to this side of the equation. From here, if it goes, it comes as plus. Here it is plus, here it comes as minus in this side. So minus 2 by 21 plus 3 by 5 comes here minus 3 by 5. Minus x goes the between plus x. So now we can rewrite as x is equal to minus 2 by 21 minus 3 by 5. Just I am rewriting this equation. X is equal to minus 2 by 21 minus 3 by 5. Again we are having two rational numbers for subtraction, but the denominators are not same. What is the LCM for 21 and 5? Is 25 is a prime number, so directly multiply. 21 into 5 is 105. 21 into 5 is 105. So see, 15 is 5, 5 is a 10. So what should we multiply with 21 to get 105? Yes, 5. So multiply 5 in the numerator, 5 is a 10. What should we multiply with 5 to get as 105? 21. That 21 should be multiplied with the numerator 3. So 21 into 3 is 63. 21 into 3 is 63. So now see minus minus. Minus minus means we have to add. So the answer is 73. 63 plus 10 is 73. And the sign is minus. Because same sign minus by 105. Whether the answer in the standard form? Yes, it is in the standard form. We are not reduce it as well as it is in the proper fraction form. Okay. So, whenever you are getting the statement problem, analyze the statement and convert the problem statement as a problem and find an answer. So, we got finally x is equal to minus 73 by 105. So, if we subtract this number from the given question here, we will get the answer as 3 by 5. You can substitute instead of x, the value 73 minus 73 by 105, and you can check whether you are getting the answer 3 by 5.